Today we're going to be talking about workplace charges, about OLEV grants, particularly just for workplace charging. I'm Nicholas Ramo. I make videos about electric car subjects every single week. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button down below. Have you ever
felt? Are you listening?
This video is slightly closer to my heart because, obviously, at work, I believe that you should be entitled to charge your car up. I believe that all charges for workplaces should be funded exactly the same as a house, or even more so. The reasons behind me thinking this are because most people won't be able to have a home charger fitted. Now, I did a video when I very first started YouTube and had pretty much hardly any subscribers, which was why I moved house to fit an electric car charger. And then since then I've done guest vlogs with Elle, who obviously don't have a home charger, that are able to charge using public infrastructure. Now that's fine if you live in a city like Dundee or Milton Keynes, which are really, really forward thinking cities. But what if you live in the country like me? Now if you're in the country like me, you're gonna rely on either having a home charger, but if you don't, you're going to rely on public infrastructure. Now, if there isn't much public infrastructure, you're then going to hopefully be able to charge at work. Now, currently, the OLEV grant for works are very small. There is one there, but pretty much usually works out that there's not really any much saving. Most people could probably buy the charge point themselves, pay an electrician and have it fitted themselves, unless they're having lots of charge points. If they're just fitting one or two, then the cost benefit, there's not really much push for a company to fit one. In my mind, they should be 100% funded, as in all the costs, apart from if it was required groundwork. But let's say a standard installation of around about £700-800 should be 100% OLEV funded for workplaces with more than 5 employees. What this will allow is the advantage of allowing employees who can't have home chargers fitted to charge at work. The reason I'm saying 100% funded is it's going to encourage the early adoption. There's easy ways of the government paying through this, through be it a levy on electricity charges for business, adding an extra percent to the 5% tax that's already on electricity for business customers, or levying it some other way through different taxes on companies. Now, the reason it's important to set a minimum, say 5 employees, is for someone like me who works at a family company where there's only 3 of us, giving me a free charger would be great for me, but you might have people, employees, taking advantage of it for their own self-benefit of their self-employment or employees. Where if you're looking at companies with 5 plus, you mean you're not going to have people taking advantage. One charge between 5 employees should be enough to benefit 5 employees. So for every 5 employees, maybe one charger, and the grants step down. First one free, second one 80% funded, and then step down the funding that way. This will encourage a lot more chargers to be fitted at workplaces. Now, I also think that the law should go further. They should put into planning law that any new commercial sites being built or offices being built should be made to have charging infrastructure fitted into those staff car parks at the time of being built. There's no reason why this should not be happening now. It needs to happen, and it's about time we start to think forward, because every employee in the future is going to have an electric car. Some employees, especially in the centre of London and places like rural areas where there's a lot of terraced houses with no parking, there needs to be other places to charge. And supermarkets and stuff like that, and general car parks for shopping, won't be enough to meet everyone's needs. We're going to have to start putting them at workplaces. Now, HMRC have advised stuff on tax regarding cost per mile for EVs. So there's a lot more incentives and stuff for leasing cars for employees to look at these days. I'd love to know your thoughts and feelings on this down in the comments below. Do you think that we should put more of the funding costs onto workplace and start encouraging that more? Should we do what Scotland do? You know, if you look at Scotland, Scotland's an amazing place for electric cars and the thinking forward. On top of the OLEV grant that you get from the UK government, The Scottish government will top that up for houses, so they don't pay pretty much anything for a charger to be installed these days. And why stop with chargers? Why don't we go a little bit further and even talk about fitting solar to commercial properties when they're built? Solar should be fitted at the same time with charge points, and there should be more incentives, more in grants to encourage this to happen, or even just forcing it in planning law so it has to be done. But I think it would be fair to incentivise this way in some sort of government grant up front, or an extra subsidy for that solar for an input tariff for businesses, and that would encourage them to put it down there at the time of being built. Just to let you know, one of the things that I'm trying to sort out at the moment is I'm trying to get some more equipment to do some more complicated videos. I'm also after some content, so if you have an electric car that I've not driven, or you work for a company that has electric cars for sale, please get in contact with me. I'm always looking to work with new people and new providers on sourcing content for my videos. On evnick.com, I've got a list of equipment that I need. If you don't want to become a patron, then please consider looking at some equipment that I need and helping me purchase towards this. If you're not a patron, you can become a patron by clicking here. You can click subscribe down here, and you can check out my other videos, which are in the opposite corners of those two. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you again next week. Bye.